All right, so we just did a little review of yesterday's class. We wanted to find out what was going on with everything that we just did. And now we're going to continue with functions. So the first function that we introduced was, which is this one, Denise or Charles or Kevin, anybody. What's this one that I just introduced here?
Parabola?
Yes, this is a parabola. And a parabola has an axis of symmetry. What type of symmetry does the parabola have? It has Y symmetry, or they like to call it vertical symmetry. What does it look like? Well, it looks like this. Right? So this is my first one. Now I'm going to introduce a concept called domain and range. Domain is about X values. Range is about Y values. So if I look at this parabola, and I expand it here, if I look at this parabola is not only going to the left, but it's also going to the right. And what is to the left and what is to the right? Well, my X values. And what values are vertical? Those are my Y values. So think of range like the elevator. And think of the X values as the train. The parabola is going to go from negative infinity to positive infinity for the values of X. So I understand that a lot of people get confused with these arrows. But these arrows are not only going up, they're also going to the left, and they're also going to the right. So whenever you are asked for a domain for a parabola, you're going to say, and you're going to write an interval notation, negative infinity to positive infinity, because the arrows are going to the left and to the right. They're also going up, but we'll talk about that in a moment.
I'm confused. Wouldn't the X values stop like right at the bottom? Why is it infinity?
So you're correct. They start at the bottom at 0, 0. And there's a negative 1 here. There's a negative 2, a negative 3, and a negative 4. If I go up, 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 isn't this negative 4 here? Up, 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 up. Isn't this negative 3?
So that means the range is also infinity or no?
So range is different because this value here is my X value, right? That I'm describing. But remember, there's also, there is also a horizontal value, and that is my Y value, right? Correct?
Yeah.
So we have to account for these values. So this is negative 2. This is negative 1. And at negative 1, the parabola is going to be negative 1. Remember the table we did? We did this table and there's like X and Y, and then we had negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. And then at 0, 0, 0, this is 1, this is 4, this is 1, and this is 4. So at 2, So at negative 2, what value is this? So this is negative 2, 4. At negative 3, it's going to be 9. At 4, it's going to be what? 16. Those are my y values. My y values are what? When it's negative 4 for x, my y value is 16. When it's negative 3 for x, my y value is 9. Why is that? Because y is equal to x squared. And what are my inputs? My inputs are my x values. So when I put here a 1, what's going to be my output? My output is going to be 1. When I put here a 2, my output is 4. When I put here a 3, my output is 9. When I put here a 4, my output is 16. These are my y values. On the left, my inputs are my x values. My outputs are my y values. So not only am I going to the left, I'm also going to the right when it comes to the parabola. And the parabola at the same time is going up. That is why these values are increasing, right? I put a 1 and I get a 1. I put a 3 and I get a 9. It's growing like bacteria. It's exponentially growing. Well, that's a different equation, but we'll talk about those later. So for domain, my values of x are going to negative infinity to positive infinity. What about my range? My range is different. What is the lowest value here? What is the lowest value in a parabola?
0, 0.
Yes, very good, Devon. It's 0, 0. So since that is my lowest value, and this is a y, and this is an x, right? My y value here would be bracket 0 to positive infinity, parentheses. And the reason why my range is at 0 is because what is the lowest value for my y value on that parabola? It's going to be 0, right? But what is the highest value for y in my parabola? Do we know where this parabola is going to stop?
No.
Nope. It's infinity. We don't know where it stops. That's why we put a positive infinity. Now, would it be correct to say that the range for this parabola is positive and negative infinity?
Yes.
Tell me why that would be incorrect. Is the parabola going to negative infinity? For y values?
No.
No. The parabola is not facing down. If the parabola was facing down, let's say it looked something like this, then this would be different, right? Here, my range would be bracket 0 to negative infinity. Look at where the arrows are going. It's going down. What values is range? Range is y values. What about domain? Domain is left and right. Remember I said it's the train. It's the x values. So that would be negative infinity to positive infinity. Why? Because it's going all the way to the left, all the way to the right. X values, left and right. X values do not go up or down. Only Y values go up and down. So you have to know these values. This is my vertex. What's the value for my vertex here? It's going to be what? 0, 0. Very important. Very important. All right. So now we introduced domain and range. We're going to do another one, but not a parabola. We're going to do something else. So hey, far, yes, go ahead.
So is the range the lowest? The range is always the lowest value. So does that mean the range is always zero?
The range is y. The range is y. So what is my vertex here? My vertex is 0, 0. Since the value of y is 0, that's my lowest point. Later on, when I give you a parabola that moved up, it's no longer going to be 0, 0. It's going to be the new value because the parabola moved up. But we're not there yet.
Okay.
No problemo. So we're trying to introduce the parabola. It has an axis of symmetry. It has y symmetry. We spoke about domain and range. And now we're going to talk about cubic. Oof, I'm erasing everything. Cubic. So that's f of x is equal to x to the third. So what's the name of this bad boy? It's a cubic. Does this have an axis of symmetry? No, it does not. This has something else. This has an origin. And what type of symmetry does it have? The symmetry is over the origin. How does it look like? Well, we're going to graph it right now. Ladies and gentlemen, x to the third has symmetry over the origin. You see this right here in blue? That is the origin. That is 0, 0. So when you have symmetry over the origin, what you have is symmetry at a 45 degree angle. It's no longer going to be left and right, as in your eyes. Remember when you go to the mirror, you're not going to have that type of symmetry. It's no longer vertical symmetry. It is now symmetry over the origin. So it's going to be at an angle. Correct. This is the Statue of Liberty. So now when it comes to domain, what do you think the domain is going to be? What do you think that the range is going to be? Domain measures x values. Range measures y values. Where do you think the values of x for this graph are going? Follow the red dots. Aren't they going to the left and as well going to the right? So here my domain would be negative infinity to positive infinity, right? Because those are my x values. And what about my y values that are going up and down? What do you think those values are going to be? What's going to be my range? Anybody? Nobody. Negative infinity to positive infinity. All of this is going to be on your midterm. So your range is going to be positive, negative, infinity. Why? Because all the values of y are going up to infinity and they're also going down to infinity, negative infinity. Up and down. This is why I gave you that purple, those vertical purple lines there. While in the blue, you have domain in the blue. This graph is going, the red graph is going left and right. Okay. So we got a cubic, we got origin, we got symmetry over the origin, we got domain, and we got range. Let's continue with this wonderful world of functions. Which one is this? This is called absolute value. Now, this one has an axis of symmetry. It's going to be very similar to the parabola. Symmetry over the y, right? Y symmetry. And they also call it vertical, right? And how does it look like when we graph it? Well, it's going to look something like this. This is not a parabola. So remember, in the blue is my domain. In the purple, or the pink, is my range. So what do you think my domain is?
Thank you.
What do you think my range is? What's my domain? It's going to look very similar to the parabola. Anybody?
Negative infinity to positive infinity.
That is correct for domain. What do you think my range is going to be?
0 to positive infinity.
That is correct. 0 bracket. Why is it bracket? Because there's a full stop at 0. It does not continue past 0 for my y value. So these are my domain and my range. Let's keep going. F of x is equal to the square root of x. Remember, there's a 2 here. Will it always be shown? The answer is no. So this is the square root. What type of symmetry does this have? No symmetry. You're like, what? What do you mean? I'll tell you in a moment why. Before I draw the square root, let me go back to the absolute value. What is the axis of symmetry here? What is my axis of symmetry here? What is the axis of symmetry here? What is the value of the green line? It's going to be x is equal to 0. X is equal to 0. What is my axis of symmetry here? And the green line. I'm gonna do you green. What's my axis of symmetry here for this parabola? My axis of symmetry here is x is equal to 0. X is equal to 0. All right, let's draw the square root of x. Oh, I'm just going to draw that in red. Is there something here that is symmetrical over the y-axis in the green? Does the green exist? No, it does not. So, no symmetry over the y-axis. Is there symmetry over the x-axis? No, there's not. That is why it's in green, because it's not there. Is there symmetry over the origin? No, there isn't, because it's in green. So there's nothing there. So what type of symmetry does the square root of x have?
None.
No symmetry. Does it have an axis of symmetry? No. What is the domain? What do you think the domain here is?
0 to infinity.
0 to positive infinity. How do I know that? Look. In the blue. In the green. No, I'm not going to put the green. Purple. Range. Range goes up. What's my range here? It would be what? Zero to what?
Infinity.
0 to positive infinity. Ladies and gentlemen, you are responsible for all of this. You, just like I spoke this today on the test, you're responsible to know the symmetries for all of these. You're responsible to know the domain. You're responsible to know the range. You're responsible to know all of these items here. And we're not done yet. Which one is this? F of x is equal to cubic root. Mm-hmm. What they said. What type of symmetry does this have? This has symmetry over the origin. Julie, I'm going to mute you. Origin, symmetry over the origin. All right, so let's graph this bad boy. We're going to do a Michael Phelps on this. So what is the domain? What is the domain? What's the domain for this function? Anybody?
Negative infinity and positive infinity.
Correct. What's going to be my range?
Same thing, negative infinity, positive infinity.
There you go. This is another way of writing it, positive, negative, infinity. All right. So we have these functions that we need to understand them. We have the parabola, we have the cubic, we have the absolute, and we got the square root. We got the cubic root. We have to understand what type of symmetry each of these has, as far as if it's Y symmetry, no symmetry, infinite symmetry. Later on when we do the circle, you'll see infinite symmetry. Square root of X has no symmetry. This has Y symmetry for the absolute value. Then we have the cubic root. Any questions so far regarding this?
So no, just to make sure, it's always going to be infinity when we're talking about this.
For these examples, yes. But there could be examples where it doesn't continue.
Oh, okay.
So let me give you an example of that. You have a parabola, right? Is the parabola continuous?
No.
No, it is not. So if this value here is, let's say, -5, and this value here for y is 5, well, actually, no, it can't be 5. It would have to be 25. This value, this point here would be -5, 25, right? So, because that's my x and that's my y. If we did domain for this, what would be my domain for this problem? Remember, you have to look at your x values.
Would it be negative 5 to infinity?
That's right. Negative 5 to positive infinity. That would be the domain for this parabola. Because there is no value past negative 5 to the left, is there? It's a full stop. And it's solid. You see this point? It's solid. What would happen if this point were open? If the point were open, then this would not be a bracket. This would be a parenthesis. You understand? There's a big difference there. Big difference. So if the circle is open, it's a parenthesis. If the circle is solid, the point is solid, like the Spanish band from Santo Domingo, oro sólido, solid gold. If it's solid gold, then it's not a parenthesis. If it's solid gold, then it's a bracket. So then this is a bracket. Okay. Now, what is my range? Or like we say in Spanish, range. What's my range? What's my range? How low and how high does this go? What's the lowest value here?
25. No.
No, the lowest value is 0, 0.
Oh, okay.
Right? That's the lowest value for y, right? What is the highest value for y?
Positive infinity.
Positive infinity, that's right. So it's going to be 0 bracket 2 positive infinity. Now remember, range measures y values only. Domain only measures x values. This is why we call domain the train. The Long Island Railroad, MTA, Amtrak. Do you see any trains flying in the air, going up or going down? No, not that I know of. They usually go horizontally, right? Left and right. Elevators, I know there's some elevators in Europe and Canada that go sideways. But we're not talking about those elevators. We're talking about the regular ones that we know about. Elevators go up and down. All right. All right. So good questions here so far. I like the questions because it shows me that you guys are, you know, using your neurological juices, which is wonderful. Wonderful, I tell you. Okay. So let us keep going. Let us keep going because there's plenty of information here. So I'm going to introduce to you the vertex form of the equation. You're like, what the hell is this? Well, I'm going to show you right now. F of x is equal to x squared, right? Now, we're going to expand it, right? We're going to expand. And we're going to do f of x is equal to x minus h squared plus k. So what did we add? We added the h, we added the k, right? And now, since we added the h and the k, we're now going to say h and k is equal to the vertex. What is the vertex? The vertex is a point. That point has an x and a y value. If the parabola is positive, then my vertex is the lowest point. If my parabola is negative, then it is the highest point. Okay, so let's talk about h. H controls movement. Movement. What type of movement? Horizontal movement, meaning left and right. That's H. What does K control? K controls vertical movement. That's up and down. Okay. Now, H is special. You do the opposite of what is given for H only. What does that mean? What does that mean that you do the opposite of what is given? Well, take a look here. Is that H positive or is that H negative?
Negative.
That H is negative. And since that H is negative, then everything is going to be negated. So you always are going to do the opposite, right? Because it starts off negative. While the K value, right, starts off positive. So what you see is what you get with the K value. So let me give you an example of this. So everybody got this, right? H and K, the parabola is positive. It's going to be my lowest point for the vertex. And if my parabola is negative, it's going to be the highest point. Okay. So let's look at a parabola. So far, we've seen a parabola that starts where? Starts at 0, 0, right? So here my vertex is 0, 0. And did this parabola move? Did it go anywhere? The answer is no, it has not moved. But I'm now going to introduce movement to the parabola. And that movement is controlled by this box. And I am going to put here a negative 2. What did I say about H? What did I say about H? You do the opposite of what is given, right? Isn't that H? Because our formula says it's this way. All right, that's my H, right? So I always do the opposite. So now how do I graph this? I start at 0, 0, right? I do the opposite. H here is now positive 2. What is my K here? What's here? For K, is there anything next to it? It's 0. There's nothing there. So my H and K here are 0. It's going to be 2, 0. It's going to be 2, 0. And what did I say my H and K is? It's my vertex. What's my vertex? X and Y. So I'm going to move 2 units to the right. I'm at 2, 0. And now I draw my parabola. My parabola has moved to the right 2 units. It has moved to the right 2 units. My axis of symmetry has changed. It is now X is equal to 2. This is my axis of symmetry. What type of symmetry does the parabola have? Has Y symmetry. What is my domain for this equation? It's going to be positive, negative, infinity. How do I know that? Because it goes to the left. It goes to the right. What is my range? My range is going to be bracket 0 to positive infinity. Now, let's do one that moves to the left. F of X is equal to X plus 2 squared. So what's my H? What's my H here? Is it 2 or negative 2?
Negative 2.
Negative 2.
What's my K? What's outside here?
0.
0. So my H and K is negative 2, 0. This is my vertex. So I'm going to go to the left, 2 units. And then I am going to draw my parabola. Again, this is not to scale, but to learn the concept. What's my axis of symmetry? My axis of symmetry is what, guys? X is equal to negative 2. What is my domain? My domain is positive, negative, infinity. What is my range? My range is 0 bracket to positive infinity. Is this a positive or a negative parabola?
Positive.
That is a positive. So far, we went from a parabola that has not moved to a parabola that moved to the right to a parabola that moved to the left. Now we're going to move the parabola up. F of x is equal to x squared plus 2. F of x is equal to x squared minus 2. Where is my starting point? My starting point is 0. But where am I going? Is this K or H? What is this? That is K. So I'm going to go up 2, and then I'm going to draw my parabola. I went up 2 units. So what is my axis of symmetry? My axis of symmetry here is what? X is equal to 0. What is my domain? My domain is still positive, negative, infinity. What is my range? Did my range stay the same as 0? No, it's now at 2. 2 to positive infinity. My range has changed. My range has changed. What is my vertex? My vertex is what? What's my x? My x is 0. What's my y? 2. So my vertex is 0, 2. Because my k value does not change. Whatever I'm given for a k value, that is what I keep. My h value is always the opposite. Okay, let's do the next one. I start at 0, and it goes down 2 units, and then I draw my parabola. What is my axis of symmetry? My axis of symmetry is x is equal to 0. What is my domain? My domain is positive, negative, infinity. What is my range? Anybody want to tell me what my range is? What's this value here?
Negative 2.
So this is negative 2 to positive infinity. What is my vertex? My vertex is 0 for x. My y is negative 2. So far, we've moved the parabola to the right, to the left, up and down. Now we're going to do both up and down. So we're going to move the parabola. We're going to move the parabola to the right. And we're going to move it up. We're going to move the parabola to the left. And we're going to move it down. Okay, so now let's do this. Okay, the first thing I need to do is my vertex. What's my vertex? What's my vertex for the one on the left?
0.
Look at the value for H. Look at the value for K. Look at the value for H, look at the value for K. We're doing the one on the left.
The K is the vertex, right?
H and K. Mm-hmm.
So it would be positive 2 and positive 2?
Correct.
And the other one being negative 2, negative 2.
Correct. So if we go to the right 2 units and we go up 2 units, this is my vertex now. This is 2, 2. And then my vertex on the other one is negative 2, down 2, I'm here. This is negative 2, negative 2. That's my vertex. Now, from that, can you tell me what my axis of symmetry is? What is my axis of symmetry?
2.
Out, it's going to be x is equal to 2, x and then is the equal one to negative 2. 2. There you go. I'm going to draw my parabola. There you go. What is my domain? What is my range? My domain is negative, positive, negative, infinity. What is my range? My range is, what is the highest value for y here?
2.
So it's going to be bracket 2 to positive infinity. What is my domain here? My domain here is positive, negative, infinity. What is my range? My range is
negative 2
to positive infinity. These are brackets. They both have y symmetry. Y symmetry. All right. Let's keep going. So now we've seen f of x is equal to x squared. We know that if we draw this, it's going to look this way. We know my vertex is 0, 0. We said that the domain here is positive, negative, infinity, and my range is bracket 0 to positive infinity, right? But what happens when you put a negative in front of your function? That means that it's now being reflected over the x-axis. Whenever you have a negative placed in front of your equation, your values are now going to be reflected over the x-axis. So my vertex is still 0, 0. My domain, it's still going to be positive, negative, infinity. However, my range here is what? My range is going to be a little different. 0 to what? To negative infinity. Negative. Now that we have the negativity, now we could do one that has moved to the right. 2 units has gone down 2 units and is going to be reflected over the x-axis. But now we have all of them in here. Ay, caramba, salvador. Ooh, easy, easy stuff. What's my h and k?
Positive 2 is h, and k is negative 2.
Correct. That is the first thing you do. This is negative, this is positive 2, negative 2. Good. Then you ask yourself, is there a negative outside the function? And what is, what's the answer?
Yes.
Yes, there is. Since there is a negative outside my function, my parabola is going damn to hell. It is sad. Does this have an axis of symmetry? And the answer is yes. And what is the axis of symmetry? X is equal to 2. X is equal to 2. Remember, you got to put X is equal to 2, not just 2. X is equal to 2. X is equal to 2.
Sorry.
Very good. So what's my domain? What's my domain?
Remember. Negative infinity and positive infinity. Negative
That's
positive infinity.
Right.
Sorry.
Correct. Because my x values is domain, right? This is domain in the blue. Look, this is domain in the blue. That's domain in the blue. All x values. And my y values is range. So this is range going down. So what is the highest point here for my
negative
y value?
Two.
Correct.
Would it be negative infinity?
That's right. Okay. You see it? I know it looks hard, but it isn't. You got to practice. What I don't like about the books is that a book may have one example, but it doesn't work all the examples. And this is called transformation. So we've had, you know, like Optimus Prime and Megatron and Transformers, this parabola has transformed, right? It's like when your professor goes to ay Dios mío, how do you call that place? The nail salon, right? And I say, yo, I want you to do my nails. I want you to do my feet. Nice foot massage. You know, they're transforming my nails. Of course, I'm not going to put any color or nail polish on it, but I like my nails to be clean. I want my nails, mis garras, limpias, and mis pies limpios. I like my feet and my nails clean. So I transform myself. Of course, for Halloween, I'm going to put a wig on and I'm going to look like Freddy Krueger. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to scare a lot of kids. I'm like, boo-ah. But again, does that mean that I'm not me? No. And it's the same thing with the parabola. Just because the parabola has moved to the right, has moved to the left, has gone up, has gone down, has gone to the right and up and to the left and down, or it has been reflected over the x-axis, or it has moved to the right and gone down too and moved to the right too and being reflected over the x-axis. Does that mean it's still not a parabola? No, it's still a parabola. You just had transformations. Transformers, more than meets the eye. Okay, never mind. I'm losing my mind here. Okay, lots of math. Mucho matemática.